Fury, what the hell?
You mind telling me what the hell you're doing in here? Memory serves, I shit-canned you into oblivion a few days ago.
I didn't like the way we left things between us the other day. You know? I mean, for real, though. You know, us brothers gotta stick together. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh. And you thought you'd demonstrate that by breaking and entering?
I wanted to share my favorite liquid lunch with you. Pappy Van Winkle. 23 years of distilled perfection. I figured we could settle our beef like, you know, proper gentlemen. Pappy, you now did yourself on this one.
This the real thing?
$5,000 worth of 24-karat liquid gold.
Should I be worried about poison?
Poison? No. What, nanotrackers?
Nanotrackers. Then maybe I should pour this out and make myself a fresh one.
You can do whatever makes you feel comfortable.
Hi, everyone. Bart here with Tully Television. And I want to thank you for stopping by, liking, commenting, sharing all that beautiful YouTube stuff. I hope that today is the day we earn that subscription. But today, what we're getting into is Secret Invasion Episode 4, entitled Beloved. Directed by Ali Salim, written by Kyle Bradstreet. Cast Samuel Jackson as Nick Fury. Ben Mendelsohn, son as Talos, Amelia Clarke as Gaia, John Tito as Rhodey, Nisha Alia as Rava / Lady Skrull Rhodes, Kingsley Ben-Adir-Gravix, Charlene Woodward as Priscilla, and Dermot Mulroney as the President of the United States. We start off this episode basically where we had left Gaia being attacked by Gravix and left for passing over to the next realm. But we see as she's laying there that she was able to gain the memories of how to use the Super Skrull machine, and she was able to change herself into a Super Skrull before leaving the facility and Gravix attacking her, which obviously Gravix was unaware of. So Gaia is alive, and she winds up having a talk with Talos through later on in the episode about her willingness to follow Talos still and follow Fury still, but they need a plan because whether they like it or not, Gravix has a plan and they're going to do the plan no matter whether they have a plan or not. Gravix is going to be Gravix, all right? And so Talos' plan is to help save the president, to show the world that not all the Skrulls are going to be menaces to the world. Which is a good idea, but we all know that in the court of public opinion, whether you do something right or not, things are always going to get cherry-picked about things, and if you're cherry-picking conversations or certain responses and visual things that people say, it's very easy for people to sound like a jerk or whatever like that. But that's kind of where Gaia is at this moment with this whole thing. She just wants a home for her people. Now, we see Fury listening in on a conversation that Priscilla and Rhodes is having at this church about what to do with Fury. And we pretty much get it spelled out here that Rhodey is a Skrull, because he talks about that Priscilla needs to take care of Fury, because if she doesn't, he's going to take care of her and Fury. So you decide what how you want to handle that. And I kind of like how Skrull Roadies, I'm going to call them Scroty. Right? Scroty was talking about how he DDT'd Fury from the top rope like the Undertaker. So I DDT'd his ass. So this Scroty, I don't know why I want to keep saying Scroty. Scroty is a big wrestling fan, so cool, bro. I wonder how it is for aliens to watch Earth TV. I wonder if they had a TV on Skrullos. So basically, it's confirmed with this conversation that Rhodey is a Skrull. We see Nick Fury and Priscilla have a conversation about her mission now to kill Fury, and he knows everything, basically. And he said to her that he wouldn't change anything, even though he doesn't trust her, and she's tasked with to kill him. The reason why this episode is called Beloved is because she shared a poem with Fury very early on in the episode. It was right after the Avengers, the first Avengers movie where the Avengers saved the planet from alien invasion and Loki, and they met, and she didn't know that he formed the Avengers, but it sounded like whoever this man was who created them was a man for righteousness and to protect the weak and to protect their home. And we know what the underlying thing was for her, for that. She, you know, was saying, all right, you saved the world, but now it's kind of time to help us find our world, right? And we kind of found out throughout the years why that didn't happen and why she started feeling a certain way herself about Fury. And they kind of both shoot at each other, but realize that they can't kill each other because they're both, you know, at this point, excellent marksmen or whatever like that. They could have shot each other and they both would have been laying there, right? Bleeding out. But they missed each other on purpose. And there's still an air of apprehension between the two of them. But Priscilla is ready to put her faith back into Fury, whether she believes in it or not, in herself. Because for him to hear some of the things about how people view him is bothering him now. People think he's a weak old man, and he doesn't feel like a weak old man, but at some point, is he the same Fury that he once was when we met him so many years back in Iron Man 1? Only he can answer that himself. So he then sneaks in and winds up meeting Skrody, right? And we for sure see Rhodey in her Skrull form taking a shower, and they change back to Rhodey, and Nick Fury sitting there with a $5,000 bottle of bourbon, and Skrody keeps thinking that, like, Fury's trying to poison them or whatever, and he didn't poison them or anything like that, but he made a joke about nanotech, and it wasn't really a joke. It was a liquid tracker, right, in there with the bourbon, and they were able to follow Skrody to where they were going, and where they were going was where Skrody was going to meet the president, and then go meet the Russian delegation. And Skrody must have drank a lot of that bourbon, because the president was like, are you drunk? Like, you stink, bro. Like, a bourbon, bro. And he made a joke to one of the Secret Service guy's like, let's get Mr. Rhodes here a large cup of coffee. But I'm assuming Skrulls have a higher liquor tolerance than humans, from how he was trying to make it sound. It'd be amazing how they weren't stumbling on each other. Upon himself, or herself, I should say. So as they get into the caravan to go to where they're going, he alerts Gravix on their en route and what position car they are in the caravan and all that. And Gravix and his people attack with two helicopters. And this was a pretty action-packed ending scene. It was a short episode, but very action-packed near the end. Again, Nick Fury's acting in this is phenomenal. I can't state that enough. To see him and Don Cheadle play off of each other is fantastic. When was Rhodey overtaken? The running theory is that he was taken during that Civil War, after the Civil War, and he was in the hospital from being shot down in the sky. It could be that he was taken from the beginning, right? There's no way of really telling until they kind of save Rhodey and everyone else. He's probably going to be in that big room that we see in the upcoming in the trailers for upcoming episodes of all those like thousands of people. He's probably in there, and Nick Fury will eventually save him and others that are in there. Priscilla's person, who she overtook. She happened to have been dying of, I believe, cancer, and had asked her permission to continue her life. So what she did was, when she passed away, she had buried her and just continued living her life until now. And that's why no one was really questioning whether she was like different or not. Because, you know, she could just talk it up to the experience of being sick, you know, any little thing that she might have and you can't really forget because you can draw the memories from the person, right? They can. So you can remember what your first dog's name was. I remember Pepper. Oh, yeah, I remember Pepper, the little doggy dog, you know, that type of thing. Gravix shows some of his group powers and extremist powers in this episode. They looked pretty decent, man. The CGI was looking okay. Better than She-Hulk, I will say that. And Talos was being protected by Nick Fury in Secret Service as he kept trying to pound that thick glass, that tempered glass that protects the president in vehicles. That's supposed to be like rocket proof and bulletproof and all this other proof. And at one point, one of the Secret Service seen Talos switching back and forth from human to Skrull form. And Fury is like, no, he's with us. He's with us, please. He's trying to help the president. And a good thing that I heard also why people were more accepting of the Asgardians as opposed to maybe being accepting of the Skrulls, is because the Asgardians in their natural form look human. The Skrulls in their natural form obviously look like they're a foreigner of the planet, you know what I mean? Wherever planet they go to, unless they're camouflaging themselves from how the people look on that planet. So, but, you know, that doesn't... the Skrulls need a home, and that doesn't mean take over someone else's world, but at the same time, people can be very weird with what's going on, especially with just visual looks. So that is, you know, where the problem is going to be trying to share this planet. But, however, some of the Skrulls are really trying to work this out in a peaceful way. Gravix is tired of waiting. Gravix is tired of being disappointed. And I really love Gravix's motivation in this series. It makes sense. I like the actor portraying him. At the end of the episode, the president is eventually saved and driven off by Nick Fury. But it comes at the cost of Talos's life, which was taken by Gravix. So now Nick Fury owes him two. Maria Hill and Talos. But he knew the mission was more important to save the president at this moment. We're down to the last two episodes. I'm hoping we can finish big. I'd like to see maybe one more reveal or two more reveals before the end of the series. Maybe have a big reveal at the end of the series in the post-credits scene, maybe. We'll find out in a couple weeks, I guess. The parts I like about this episode is seeing Priscilla and Fury falling in love, even though Fury knew it was a bad idea. And it was a shame to see Talos go. Gaia walks out with Super Skrull powers. And now basically it's going to be Fury, Priscilla, and Gaia trying to go after Gravix and his plan. And we'll see if there's any more obstacles that get in their way in the next 2 weeks, I guess, right? You let me know down below what you guys think of Secret Invasion. And until next time, peace, Knuckums.